Hello everybody, today I like to talking about the laboratory so-called particle size analysis. Because now according to the COVID situation here in our university, so we cannot conduct the lab in our university. So I have the other package or the other tool to get the grain size distribution by using the computer vision. You can get the particle size distribution of the sand at your home. Okay, let me see. And this one, I developed this code by myself by using the code is so-called OpenCV. And this code is right in Python language. So let's see what's going on. So according to the traditional method or conventional method we use is the method is so-called sieve analysis. We just put the soil into the mesh, something like this. If the soil here is larger than the mesh, the soil particle will retain on the mesh. If the soil is particle is smaller than the mesh, it will fall into the corresponding sieve and come here. So this one is a sieve analysis or mechanical analysis. We use it to see what is the grain size of the soil for a really long time. I think more than 30 to 40 years. It's been maybe time consuming and maybe, for example, if we stay in the field, we don't have any kind of machine, how can we do? How can we know the gradation of the soil? So today I will introduce a new method, it's so called computer vision. So it's something like this. So this one, I get the sand from the sandbox of my kit, and I place the sand particle onto the paper. The soil is something like this. If I have some tool to capture the size of the sand here, okay, so capture what is the size of the sand, what is the size of the sand, use computer to do it with reference to the target. If I know this one may be 2 centimeters, I can calculate the size of this particle and the size of the other particle immediately. So this one, after I use the code to detect, is something like this. The computer will detect the soil particle into the rectangular here. So each rectangular maybe just see something, they have the size of the width and maybe height or something. That if we get the average of the width and height, we can know the particle size. If we combine every particle size, every soil grain into the curve, we can get the curve immediately. This one is the gradation curve that we obtain from my program or my app. This one I write out by myself, and this one is the percent final. This one is particle size in millimeter, and you can see this soil. This one is show for the fine grain soil. This one show for the of gravel. So this sand, we have no gravel portion in the soil, and we still have little bit part of the fine grain soil. And also in this program, we show the user that we have the fine grain about 34%, and we have the Cu equal to 1.1, Cc equal to 3.3, and it's not only like this, we also classify a soil into the so-called SP, is the polygraded soil. So that means if you stay in the field, you press the soil into my paper and you use the mobile phone to take the picture, you can get this one is gradation curve immediately. And right now I developed this program for a while. Maybe it's not complete. It's right now it's about version, I think 0.1a. It's under developing. If you guys have some feedback, you can send some feedback to me. I can revise for the bug or revise some feature if you want. The first one for 1.1a is the perspective correction. Okay, if we use the camera and the camera is not perpendicular to the plane, your maybe your target or AUCO is something like that. We have to correct this one, change from this to be the square one. So that means in this version is different than the other version. We have to correct the perspective of the paper to get the correct size of the soil. And it's not like that in this version we will propose for the so-called gradation curve of the soil and can classify a soil and then tell the user about the file content. So how can you use it? This one I develop the code in, because if I put the code in my computer it is quite difficult to use, so I put this code in the so-called web app. I use the Flask in Python and upload this web this app into the web, and so that means everyone in the world can use this app to see the gradation curve. So how can you use this? Let me show you. Firstly, you just press this one. This one is the particle size dot helogf dot com. Yes, the code is something like this. It's quite easy. The user interface is not quite fancy. This one it make it quite easy to use. So you have the download file. You download this file first. Okay, so this one is a plain paper with the one target. You download this file and you print out. When you print out, you get the piece of paper. You just put the soil into this paper and take the picture. So after you take the picture, you will come back to this one, and you take the picture. You just choose the file. Okay, my file is something like this. Okay, my file is something like this. So this one is my file with the soil particle in it, and this. And after that, I press the upload image. This one is quite slow because I press this one on the so-called free server, so it takes for a while because firstly the program will sleep. When we do something, they have to wake up and respond. This one finished. You can see this one is the gradation curve for our soil. You can see that they have the file content is about 8.4%, and the soil type is the dual symbol is SP or SC or SM. If you would like to know SC or SM, you have to conduct the so-called the attribute limit test. And it's not only this, it's a way to show you the detector of the image to see what's going on about the image detection of the soil. Okay, it's quite good program. If you have some, maybe if you have some bug or error or some feedback, please contact me in this Facebook. I have the link of this Facebook here. You can go to my page and you can message to me to show to tell me how can I develop this one in the future. So this one is quite easy to use. And the problem, we still have some problem of this program, because right now if we use this one for the 5-grain soil, maybe it's small, the soil particle is really small, they still have some error. So I will try to revise it later. But if the soil particle is maybe larger than 0.1 millimeter, then the result is quite accurate.